Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one, why don't we make some gears? Make this gear here out of wood. Now, so that the grains are always going outwards on the teeth, it's made out of 8 triangles of 45 degrees each. To get a rough 45 degrees, I can take a piece of paper, bend it over. There's my 45 degrees. And I want to go down this stick, which is about a centimeter, I suppose, by that wide enough, and go straight down the line. Not this way, nor that way, but down the center line. And mark it. And I can cut two at a time if I go point to point. So I can cut that way and that way. Plane one side flat of each of those. Put some glue on and glue them. Now, with your plane in the shooting board, you want to get that as close to your right angle, evenly spaced as possible. And flipped over so that we can now glue those together and you've got half of your gear. And plane those two straight. If we've done everything correctly, we should be able to divide those into its 8 portions straight down those lines. Then we can draw a circle from the center with a compass to give at least a basis to then use some dividers to divide those quadrants into 3. And if we've done everything correctly, we should be able to walk that compass around the circle and have them coincide with those lines. I'm going to have a square axle there on one end so that it doesn't shift. So I'm going to use a chisel and use as reference 4 of the quadrants and make that square hole. Marcando el centro, puedo también marcar el cuadrado. Mark those 4 points as well. And at least the depth of that. Then I can make that square. Thank you. so we can find the centre of that to put our axle into. Now I'm going to have a pitch or a tooth width of 7 millimetres, and so that's going to be 14 between these two lines. So I can go in and out and find more or less where I think that is. Do it on a few of them. And then with a compass from that centre point, get a good average of those points, and that will be our circle pitch. And half of those gaps is going to be a tooth and a gap. To get the addendum, it's going to be halfway between those holes and down that way, back from the other way, and that is going to be our addendum height. So that gives us our addendum, at least our maximum of our addendum, and roughly the same size the other way to get our addendum. Outside addendum, inside addendum. I can get rid of a bit of the excess just up to that addendum line or a little bit further out from it. Now before I cut them, it's a good idea to use a sharp knife and score where I'm going to be cutting to delineate and help with the cutting. I've marked the edges as well. Putting it on its axle, I have a board with two boards clamped to that and another one underneath, so it sits in there and I can clamp that. On my blade, I've put a few layers of tape just so to make compensate for that kerf there, and I'm laying it on the table flat, and that will very carefully go down the line into the gap on the inside line to cut out the gap, leaving the tooth. So now we cut out the gaps. Next, we can do a rough trim up of those points with a knife or a chisel. And we'll be doing finer touch-ups later. Then put a metal axle in. Now they will mesh okay, but they'll need a bit more work for them to run smoothly. Remembering that this is our pitch width here, should be the same distance as the gap, and so we don't want to bring that down any further, but we can curve those with the sandpaper. Now there are basically three places it can bind. It can be that the tip is too long, like in this case, or it can be that this tooth is striking this outside face as it enters, so that needs to be reduced, or it can be this side of the tooth as it's coming out can be striking too much pressure there at the same time as that one's coming in. So check those three faces, coming in too deep or going out. Like that one there is too tight coming out, that one is just about too tight, too deep, and that one there is striking, so that needs to be reduced for that to come in. So when you get it into your apparatus with a handle and everything on, it should work pretty decently.